By the way, I just want to bring something up. Wendell didn't in his speech, but Wendell is someone who saw 11 rather remarkable photographs of San Francisco. And I just want to ask Wendell to tell you about this, if you would.
Okay, Billy was taken on a trip in time, and Semyasi asked him what he would like to see. And he said, I would like to see San Francisco and the next big earthquake that's been forecast or predicted for it. So she took him someplace in time and showed him San Francisco undergoing a major earthquake where it was shaking buildings down. And she allowed him to take pictures on the viewing screens with his camera. And there was one picture of the Transamerica Tower breaking about two-thirds of the way up from the upper right-hand side as you looked at it from, I think, from the east down to the lower half left-hand side at about a 30-degree angle, and it was beginning to slide off. And there was plumes of fire and plumes of smoke and plumes of water from the broken lines and pipes and everything in the photograph. Now, as soon as the photograph, the first problem came is when Billy came home with the pictures. Lee and I and Tom and Britt were sitting around the kitchen table, and he opened the envelope and looked at them and passed them around. And we all looked at the pictures. And there wasn't just one picture. There were 11 pictures in the envelope. The 11 pictures showed different scenes of San Francisco going down. And after that, just a few days after that, Semyasi picked Meyer up again and said she wanted to have to take the pictures to look at the negatives. And when she refused to give them back, she said, you showed the pictures against our instructions to others that can affect the lives of a lot of people, and we're not going to return the pictures to you. So he never got them back. All it was ever saw was the 11 that we looked at. And the one picture that had the Transamerica Tower in it matched a painting that was done for GEO magazine by a staff artist fairly closely, but not really exact. The buildings were the same, but the plumes of smoke and fire and gas were not in the painting. A few of them were, but not like in the picture that we saw. And other buildings were collapsing. There was a rectangular building with towers on both ends, and the towers were falling in, smashing the middle, and things like that. There was also, we were looking for cars in the streets to try to gauge some time for this to happen. And the cars that we couldn't recognize on the street, and there weren't too many on the street, by the way, the streets were not completely closed as in the GEO painting. The GEO painting showed the streets impassable for emergency vehicles. In Billy's pictures, they were not impassable. They could have been cleared with a bulldozer or something like that. But we were looking for a time somehow, and so there were a number of cars shown in the pictures. And the car that we had never seen was a car that looked more like a Volkswagen than anything else, a smooth contoured car. It had tiny fins beginning to be drawn up on the rear fenders, and it had glass. The windshield glass came clear back to the back of the front door, so that the front door in the car opened in a glass frame. And we haven't seen anything like that yet, but we do see the skylights getting bigger and bigger and going farther back. So it's not going to happen tomorrow, but it may happen in the next 10 or 15 years. And those other 11 pictures were quite graphic. They showed some scenes that overlapped, so we could see that as we looked at the pictures that they were all related, and it was very impressive to see. It looked like a lot of destruction, but they told Billy at the same time that this could be avoided by mass mind concentration, people that gave up harmful ideas and wars and things like that that add energy, negative energy to the situation. Enough of that could have stalled this all off. It didn't have to happen.